a day in the Valley Tree. Good morning, friends. It's 10 to 7 on Saturday, the 3rd of August, I believe. I think that's correct. I'll just look. I'm sitting down by the river. There's a couple of rough sleepers close by, I think. They're fine, they're no problem to me. But yeah, last night, this fucking bullshit, fucking, a little fucking gang trying to fucking do bollocks with fucking intimidations, fucking seizure stuff. Just F off, you know. I'm a 55-year-old fucking woman. Keep out my fucking face with your silly, childish bollocks. It felt like I was going through a schoolyard last night, going up to go to my room. And this is beyond a joke. What, because I dare to speak out about corruption within high-ranking police officers. And you see how I'm still being treated here as the prime witness, the... See that? It's under the line there in flashing lights. Don't forget I've also gone to Russia and I've asked for help with the counter-surveillance for the witness intimidation I'm going against, because I'm speaking out against corruption within this country, because this country here, the great UK, spends his whole life pointing his finger at Russia and saying, oh, they're so corrupt, they're so dirty, and look at their criminals, they're so intelligent, they all play chess. I mean, come on, for God's sake, this is beyond a joke. I'm sick to death of this witness intimidation, I really am. I am a witness, I'm the only witness left. The rest have been intimidated out and away. They've had to back down. I've already taken three broken shoulders, three broken hands, broken fucking ribs. And you think I'm putting up with the schoolyard bullying in the YMCA? Because I'm not. And yes, I am looking to relocating, and because I'm now going privately through this court, I cannot afford for any little 22-year-old idiots and their little fucking gang to try and intimidate me in a moment, because now I've lost legal aid and I'm going privately. If I lose the case, I am looking at a bill of about a few hundred thousand fucking pounds. Now, I have no money. I am a homeless, unemployed victim here, victim of police corruption within high-ranking police officers. And it's been cover-up after cover-up after cover-up. And I have gone to the Russian embassy, to the Honourable Ambassador Yakovenko, Alexander Yakovenko, for help. And I'm still waiting for someone from fucking Russia. Excuse my language there, Russia, use the F word in front of your lovely country. To come to speak to me about the things that I cannot discuss with you, friends, because it's under the data protection law. Everything I've said to the Honourable Ambassador is between me and him. My paralegal knows, she has to know, because she had to give her consent for him to ask her for everything she has on me. But I still need a debrief on this, please, because you're all in Russia. But anyway, so the stupid idiots are trying their best with the witness intimidation over there, or whatever they're doing. They're just playing very silly games, and they don't realise what's actually going on and how nasty things can get. It can get nasty for everyone included, especially me. And I'm not going to be on the end of any more broken limbs, because I dare to speak out against a high-ranking Masonic police officer who has now been to court three times. I was only witness on the last time in court, and every time it's been more full pay and suspension. Officer, don't you worry, we're Masons, we'll cover it over. Well, I must have evidence, I must have good evidence, or I would never have gone to the Honourable Alexander Yakovenko for help, please, for shoulder stuff. Anyway, I'll just carry on with my music down now. I'm down by the river before the fucking bullshit starts when I go back to recharge my phone. I'll catch you later, friends. Saturday is a good day for witness intimidation and shit hole like this, because no one notices, because these are posh people usually. Yeah, well, I notice in terms of Russia. Okay, bye for now. I say that's where Diana, that's where I do see comrades. And bye for now, genuine friends, genuine ones. The rest of you can go pluck yourselves. Off phone. Oh, don't record phone.